My name is Ella. I'm originally from New Delhi, India. I moved over here a few years ago, and it was like a cultural shock to me.
Okay, so how many years ago has it been since you moved to the U.S.?
About 7.
And what part of the United States did you move to?
First, I moved to Hollywood, California, and I was at music school, but I was subleasing. So which meant that at times if the person that's subleasing the apartment gets kicked out, you basically get kicked out. And I was unaware of that because I was from a different country. You know, I got kicked out of there, and then I was basically not in Hollywood no more. You know, it wasn't Hollywood anymore for me. When I got kicked out, I started, asking friends, family for favors, stuff like that. Somehow, due to one of my friends, you know, I ended up in the city of Compton. Big culture shock for me, yeah. You know. Even though that's not originally where I'm from, and I've stayed in a lot of different, cities and parts of LA County, that's where I felt the most love for who I was, you know. I could just be myself, I could be, you know, from India, whoever I am, because it's so much of a melting pot.
Do you find that black people judge the least?
Yeah, to be honest. Really, you know, a lot of people tell me that, like, I'm one of the real life examples of how black people are the least judgmental and the least racist despite what they actually go through, you know?
Yeah,
it's ironic.
It's crazy because when you look in black neighborhoods all across the country, they have accepted everybody who moves into their neighborhood.
Right?
Yeah, but when they move into another neighborhood, they don't get
it. Yeah, they're like ostracized in a way.
So what was it like when you, I assume when you got to Compton, you was hanging out with a lot of blacks or Mexicans or both?
I'd say a mix of both, to be honest, because, you know, times change. Even if you're, say, it's a primarily African-American neighborhood, it's still people that grow up and, you know, they're non-black, but they're under that community. They love those people. They grow up with them, go to schools with them. So that's what really makes me comfortable in L.A., because even in different cities I've been in, you know, L.A. and Compton, they're the most, like, diverse. You know, you'll find people of all types of races here and, you know, all types of backgrounds. So it's just, I fit in somehow.
All right, so let's take me back to India before you decided to come here. Take me back to your childhood. What is the country of India like?
The country of India is actually nothing like what people probably expect it to be. You know, I've been in so many different positions with, you know, different social, economic, like, backgrounds of, like, people that belong to different backgrounds, and all of them have one thing in common, and it's like, they don't know what actually India is, you know? So I felt like a lot of people have miseducation on what India really is.
Well, I think the word India and Indian is used for so many different things. Even
right.
Here in the U.S.,
right.
Indians mean the natives.
Right, exactly.
But it's a term that is very, it's a loosely used term.
Right, definitely.
So when you say India, maybe most people don't even know what the heck you're talking about, right?
No, you're right. You're definitely right.
Now, did you grow up in a part of India that was rural or city?
Ironically, I grew up in a part of the city that was really advanced, really modern. I went to a school where everybody spoke English. What people don't know, every state in India, we speak a different language. So for us to communicate with each other, it's mandatory for us to speak English and learn and write English.
Okay, so how many states are there in India?
27.
And each state has a different language?
I'll be damned if I mess up.
basically, you're saying there's over 20 languages?
Yeah, definitely over 20 languages. Like, if you go over, like, out west, it's different. If you go over east, it's different. If you go towards the eastern, not eastern part of India, people look Chinese, but they're dark-skinned because they're right by China. And the
is that near Mongolia?
That's right by Nepal.
Nepal, okay. Mm-hmm. All right, so of these different languages, if you learn one of them really well, like you did, mm-hmm. does it allow you to understand and know some of the other ones a little bit?
Yes and no. You know, because in America, if we go to Atlanta or Louisiana, it's English, but it got a twang on it, you know? However, in India, it's like a... Even though the sub dialect is kind of the same, it's still really different. Like, they're different words. Different words mean this different things, so it's really subjective.
And you learn English at I guess, I don't know if they call it grammar school or grade school, but you learn it young when you go to school at, what, 5 years old?
Yeah, basically you can make it past middle school or make it past high school if you don't know English.
What grade does, how old are you when you go to school in India?
4. I started at 4. I think that's the normal age too.
And what age do they start teaching English?
At 4.
At 4.
Nah, it's actually crazy because, you know, when I meet people here, they're like, wow, your English is good. But the whole time it's like British English, that's like basic English, like, you know?
Yeah. So tell me about your original language, your original dialect there in India.
I grew up speaking Hindi. Hindi is the national language, and the second national language is English. So everybody needs to know English, and everybody needs to know Hindi, but, you know.
But even though you said there's over 20 languages, but Hindi is widely known, right, throughout all the states?
Yeah, but it's not widely spoken. Like, you could still go to South India and be a complete stranger, you know.
Okay, and how has Hindi helped you in the United States, knowing that language? Has it been useful at all here?
Yeah, like, I get my 7-Eleven discount.
Oh, my God. He said he gets a 7-Eleven discount. That's got to be the funniest thing I heard all day.
Moving to Compton, the closest relationship I had to, like, an Indian person was the dude that worked at the liquor store, JJ Liquor. Shout out Rocky from JJ Liquor on Rosecrans. He was, like, probably the closest Indian I could, you know, like, I could talk to, go to, like, hey, bro, like, this is what's happening, like, in Hindi, like, you know, really feel like I'm with somebody of my culture, you know.
Okay, and what city in India did you learn Hindi and spend most of your time?
You know, I grew up in New Delhi, so that was, like, it's the capital. Growing up there, I had, like, a closed mindset. I knew that someone I had to do, you know, being a commercial job. In India, if you're not a doctor, engineer, or a surgeon, you basically, you know, you're like just another statistic, if that makes sense.
Do they use the word like peasant out there?
Nah.
The commoner?
Yeah, commoner, yeah. Because peasants are almost for farmers, yeah. You know, lots of farmers in agriculture in India.
So when you were young, did you aspire to be an engineer or a surgeon?
I don't think that was ever in my books. At some point, I wanted to be an astronaut, but, you know, yeah. Say you grow up and you realize certain shit just not for you.